Hello everyone, this is Erlin from the Experience Research Lab. Today I'm going to show you how to generate orthogonal design with SPSS. Before I start, I would like you to imagine yourself serving as a product marketing manager involved in a product development project where, as a product marketing manager, you are responsible to help the product development team to design and develop a product that is favorable, people like it, affordable, they have the budget to buy it, and most importantly, profitable, which means that the new product will bring sustainable profit to the company you are working for. So let's assume it is a mobile phone, and looking at your internal sales record, primary data from observations and secondary data on the current market trend, you understand that people love black phones. They just love it. Especially a phone with a screen size of 5.5 inch and weight of 166 gram. They love phone with large memory capacity and super high processing speed. However, the company you're working for doesn't have the budget required to develop a product that has all those best features. Even if you insist on going beyond the limit, you can tell that it will result in such an expensive product that people in your target market won't have the capacity to buy. So the question is, what is the best combination of features for the new product that people still like, want to buy, and bring profit for the company? To answer this question, you can generate orthogonal design in SPSS by going to data, clicking orthogonal design, and selecting generate. On this window, you need to define the factor name or the feature you are considering for the new product. So I'll start with the color. Color, and the label is also color. I'll click add. Because I know that people also buy phones in different colors such as white, gray, blue, and red, I'll define the values as 1 for black, 2 for white, 3 for gray, 4 for ocean blue, and 5 for red velvet. I'll click continue and I'll go back to the previous window where I can add the second factor or second feature, which is the screen size. For the screen size, I cannot write it as screen size here because it doesn't take a blank space. So I'll just type size and then, or maybe screen, and then factor label as screen size. So click add, click it here, and then define the values. 1 for 4.7 inch, 2 for 5.5 inch, and 3 for 6.4 inch. The next one is weight, so it is weight as well. Click add, click it here, divide the values. 1 for 148 grams, 2 for 154 gram, 3 for 166 gram, 4 for 188 gram, and 5 for 194 gram. So there are 5 options for the weight. I'll click continue and then add the fourth factor or the fourth feature, which is the memory. And I'll put it here as memory size, memory capacity, I mean. Okay, and then click add, click it again, define the values as 1 for 32 gigabyte, 2 for 64 gigabyte, and, excuse me, and 3 for 128 gigabyte. The last factor that I did consider for the new product is the speed, which refers to the processing speed. I'll click add here and click it again. Define the values, one for 1 GHz and 2 for 2 GHz. Click continue. I want to create a new data set where the data set name is phone design. You cannot type it as phone design here because it doesn't take blank space either. So here I'll use capital letters and small letters only. And then reset the random number seed to 2 million. I'm good to go. Click OK. So this is the output as a statistics viewer saying that I have just created an orthogonal plan. This is the title. There's a warning here. It's actually not a bad warning because it only says a plan is successfully generated with 25 cards. So let's see what these 25 cards mean. Okay, click window and go back to the data editor. So here on data view, you can see there are 7 variables. Color, this is the first factor, screen, weight, memory, speed, status. It's all designed because there is no holdout cases. This is card number one. So the card number one will display a font in ocean blue with a screen size of 6.4 inch and weight of 154 grams and memory capacity of 64 gigabyte and processing speed of 1 gigahertz. The second card will be white font with a screen size of 4.7 inch and weight of 154 grams as well, with a larger memory capacity of 128 gigabytes, 2 gigahertz processing speed. And the third card here, the ocean blue, that's the color, with a screen size of 5.5 inch, weight 194 grams, memory capacity of 128 gigabytes, processing speed of 1 gigahertz, and so on. So to view the design, I can go to data and click orthogonal design, select display. So I'll select all these 4. Click the arrow button and tick listing for experimenters and click OK. And this is the plan card. So card list, card number one, card ID is ocean blue, 6.4 inch, 154 grams, 64 gigabyte, 1 gigahertz. So card ID number 10 is black font, 4.7 inch screen, 148 grams, 32 gigabytes, and 1 gigahertz. If you use online survey platforms such as Qualtrics, Survey Gizmo, and Survey Monkey, you can have it to rotate and randomly select a certain number of cards to be shown to your respondents. For example, respondent number one will see card number 1, 4, and 7, while respondent number 2 will be shown card number 4, number 9, and number 13. Respondent number 3 will be shown card number 6, 18, and 22, while the respondent number 4 will be shown card number 15, 19, and 23. I will create another video explaining how to use orthogonal design in a survey, which is usually called as conjoint study. But for now, I will leave it here. Thank you for being with me today. For more insights into data, data entry, data transformation, and data analysis in SPSS, please subscribe, listen, and watch our content that is available in text, audio, and video format. Thank you for being with me today again, and see you next time on the next video. Cheers.